5:30, and we have a forum. Is that okay? So, I guess we'll start with the motion to approve the agenda.
So,
okay. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
I will take minutes because Holly's up too. So, if that's all right with everybody.
Okay.
Bill, you are here. You want to mention design, or anybody else who wants to chime in?
Sure.
Chairs.
Hi. Anyone else wants to comment? I think we're coming along. Anchor has met with us every month for the last several months, and we have been refining, I guess is a good word, what we think we need, and they've been very helpful. I think we have a good relationship with them. Kevin Grindle, who's been our designated contact person, the engineer, and we are making progress. And I think our goal is to design a station that meets the needs of the both towns and is sound and environmentally suited for the area, and I think we're on our way to doing that. Bob or Tom, anybody? Malcolm? John?
I think we're making pretty good progress. I know there's at least one member of the building committee that's frustrated and would like to see us move along a little slower, but from my perspective, I think everybody is listening to each other and thinking about the big picture. The way I look at it, what we have now is working fine. We have a lot of room up there for the future, and we can do composting. We could probably do anything up there we want to do. I think we need to, I'm very interested to hear what the haulers think of the plans that we like. And I'm optimistic that we can reach some agreement soon and begin building. I think we need to just get in there. We need to continue doing what we're doing. At the existing station, it's working fine. But we need to get up there and get doing stuff. And then if we need to have a place for composting, if we need to do, you know, whatever, we can build it in. Mm-hmm. I think we got a lot of room there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm in agreement. I think I'm pleased with how things are coming along. I'm pleased and interested in open topics for discussion that seem to be whether or not and where to compost, and whether or not to weigh and why to weigh. Those are still things that are up in the air yet to be finally decided upon.
I think you're making good, we are, you're making good progress. Seems like it's moving along in the last 6 or 9 months, pretty darn fast. The one thing that a couple had suggested, some of them mentioned, is bounce the idea around. I wonder, and it comes off of the statement you made, John, is about cost month after month. I was wondering if it would be beneficial if we sat down and worked with in between those meetings and took the plan and did a cut and paste, and just get some ideas that it may advance us a little bit more without spending any money. Because there's still things that need tweaking on it, and it going a month and then have the engineer come back. And I wonder if we could.
So we can actually discuss our ideas,
yeah,
separate from the engineer, because I agree with that. Sometimes when the engineer comes, I'm afraid there's so many
things.
Yeah.
Coming
in. I bet you the engineer would like that better.
Not true.
You're talking about doing that with the engineer present?
No, not present.
Right.
It'd be a work group.
Yeah. So my question was, is that an idea for the next regularly scheduled SSR?
In between. Yeah, I would. I know. Yeah. I don't want to bulk up meetings.
Yeah.
No, but
The idea was to lay this out, make a copy of it, lay it out, and cut it out, cut the buildings out, and play with them, move them around, and just have a discussion. And,
well, there are one, oh, Bill.
I think that's a good idea. I'm curious, though, I wonder, I think Kevin thinks that we're near the end of moving things around. I think he thinks we're pretty close to the end. And I'm also curious, and I kind of put him on the spot the last meeting, I said, are we 10% or 9% through our cost for putting this together? He couldn't enter it, and he hasn't yet, but he said he would. So,
but also, Bill, he, in an email to Brian 4 months ago, he said that same thing, and we need to get, you need to give us the go-ahead to start to, you know, putting these, to draw the, whatever they call them, design drawings or whatever.
Engineering drawings.
Yeah, engineering drawings together. And I'm saying to myself, you don't do that until you make sure the footprint is right, because you're going to spend, you get the engineering drawings, you spend a lot of money on engineering drawings. And then you go back and say, well, geez, we got to change this.
Yeah,
we know. You're gonna waste a lot more.
The conceptual drawing needs to
Yeah, I think, it, and I don't know if we're, I know he's anxious to get going. But, and I think there are people that, I think we all, including myself, a year ago, or less than a year ago, said we need to help to build this season.
Start. Yeah, still 2014, it's not even half over yet.
And I think, that, to be honest with you, that if we, my sense is that if we could finalize just the entrance, I think it would give us a good feeling if we just put the freaking driveway in. You know, it just get, do something.
Well, that's critical. That driveway is critical. That's why I'm anxious to see what the haulers think tonight.
But I mean, I think, John, that is pretty much, what I'm saying is that for those that, including myself, that want to see something happen, we could do that.
Well,
if we knew where it was going, we would need DEP permit and all of the full blown, and it would sort of give us a little satisfaction that we did do something this year.
Well, what if we recommend to Bill Sears, the chair, co-chair, what if we recommend tonight, I realize there's a little bit of overlap already, that a subcommittee does form even before the next week, because rather than wait 3 more weeks for them to come back, but if
just post it as a special meeting.
Yeah. And just subcommittee meets, yep. and or subcommittee gets chosen.
Maybe. Well, good. Maybe the building committee could meet. I mean,
yeah.
I think.
I think you should definitely open it up to all the members, because they certainly all have ideas.
Yeah. Yeah. So maybe it just needs to be a sense of the meeting from SSRA that we would encourage the building committee to meet sooner rather than the next meeting, and not necessarily with the engineer.
Right.
Yeah, to just have a working session, yeah, and bring your scissors and your copying paper and whatever else. And, does that make sense?
Yeah.
They can have a non-quorum meeting because they're not expected to vote on anything. They're just making recommendations.
Yeah, or they can have a quorum meeting and then choose a subcommittee.
Doesn't matter. Choose three, maybe, or three people, or?
Well, I think the whole committee.
Okay. Well, I think the committee could be.
No, I mean, repeatedly, or just once. We'll leave it up to you.
Okay.
You all decide.
I think if we met for a few times, we could really, you know, get a good jump start. And we do, and I admit, when poor Kevin's here, we throw a lot on his plate.
Yeah. And a lot comes
in. I don't know how he absorbs it all, personally. But
yeah, and a lot comes on the hard plate when you get this book before you, and you, yeah, you're trying to absorb it all, listen to people's comments, and
well, can you do that? Schedule a special meeting, sort of after the fourth.
Yes. Yeah. Some right.
Yes.
And the other thing I want to mention is that, you know, there's some information or comments coming out of track, and you know, I over the past year or so, you know, there have been. I got the sense that the building committee was waiting for information from track and wasn't getting what they needed. So it's not meant to usurp the building committee's work in any way. if we see something, another thing that was mentioned, I believe what my email was, I didn't know where it was, this gate height or guard height in the discussion of track was considered a showstopper. And so I didn't put that, but these things are put out there with just ideas coming from another vantage point or group. The building committee is welcome to do whatever they want with it. As Bill Reed, you know, sent back some comments. I thank you for those comments. These are just another set of eyes looking at it, giving you some information. And you can look at it. As Bill Reed said, I think the scale, having anchored to a scale analysis is good, but I question these other things. The building committee can do whatever they feel is appropriate. It's not, you know, these are just ideas. And I understood from the comments over my peers that the building committee was looking for that type of input. So we're not trying to usurp the building committee's work. We're trying to supplement it and be helpful, as I hope that the building committee wanted us to do.
No, I think that the help of working with track closely is a must with us. And if we talk about isolationism, I mean, we can be off on ourselves wasting a lot of time without, you know, we need to combine our thoughts to get this thing right. And I know we're different committees, but I think it's been very beneficial. I don't think that we don't feel held up, and I think we're working in unison right on the line. I feel good about it.
I just want to be clear that the building committee can do whatever in its wisdom it decides with those comments. They're there to help. Like, I'll give an example. I went down on Sunday, and a 42, I can, but I had a garbage can for the apartment. I can get them over the gate that's there now. I can get them over a 42-inch rail, but I shouldn't at my age. It strains my upper chest, and I will probably have sense enough to say, don't lift this garbage can, it's too heavy, up that high, because you're gonna cause problems. So that what Track talked about was that 42-inch height with the bars is the standard we need to go by. It's almost a showstopper, and what you have to do is go to a tipping floor and pick it up and load it. It's the only way we can think of. And the bulky waste, this is the bulky waste daily in this way. So I didn't put that down in the comments, but didn't know where it was that I sent to Kevin. But that was a serious issue that Track discussed, as to what is the requirement, and if it's 42 inches with 10-inch bars,
right.
Then it's an obstacle that may require a whole redesign. I don't know.
That's something we definitely should work out in the, or at least some ideas in the mid-month meeting, if you want to call it that.
Yeah.
That's, we've had a lot of different ideas on how to go all the way from wire to try to control product blowing up out of the hoppers with openings in them to dump into. I saw one in Maine like that recently, and it seemed to work fine.
Yeah. I think what it is what does the building code require?
Correct, exactly.
You know, and you're more familiar, but like we don't want to get to the point where Hotchkiss School was there to put up a 36-inch rail at the opening day, only to find out it's supposed to be 42 inches. And have a rack of weld on the top.
That might be something, I would think that was something.
Yes.
Right off the top of their heads.
Did that come about because of the OSHA?
It started from the OSHA, and then we realized that that OSHA was protecting employees,
right.
But then we had to protect.
By the OSHA code, we have to protect the union.
Yeah, and so that sort of grew out of, and that's why I asked Brian to put on the thing. But that was another thing that Track discussed that. They don't know how to work their own. Because I can't I can't get the garbage can over 42 inch ground, or should I? I know enough not to, let's put it that way. So I don't know what I would do. I can't figure out how I would deal with that.
Tipping for sounds.
I know it's
a lot of extra
work. I know, Tom, but that's what we need to know.
I agree.
You can't get there and find that, you know, people my age can't use the transfer station.
I can't remember what was in, what was it, Adam, that we went to, that most recent one that had just opened, that Anchor Design, but they had three or four of those. I just can't remember what they had.
I think they had a rail.
They had a rail, but I mean, it was working, and it had to be pretty recently decoded. Yeah. So I think Anchor can answer that.
Yeah. And if it's a code, you know, if it's something like you have at Ridgefield, then, you know, we could deal with that.
Yeah,
we get a garbage can and get up on that one rail and tip it in.
Yeah, okay.
But if it's
well, those are the details for this little subcommittee.
Yeah, but that change, that little item can change the whole design. It's like the tail light of the dog, right?
Okay. Well, maybe you can put together a punch list of things. Maybe you can get Kevin to answer a few of them ahead of time. To speed up the process a little bit. So good.
Yeah, it would be good to check with, well, I would assume to start with Mike Fitting to see what the building code requires of it, and Brian must have the information on the ocean.
Yeah.
Just make sure those two aren't diametrically opposed and they're button heads rather than sides.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah, good point.
Yeah. All right, anything else? Questions? Okay. The financial update, I guess we wait until we get the numbers. But at this point, we're still really, the role of SSRA right now is just to work with the building committee. We don't have we haven't set up any financial, autonomous financial group, and we probably won't until this is completed and we move in.
So Anchor will be building Salisbury or equal parts of
authority? Has that to check it now?
Yeah, they've been billing the authority to Joe.
Oh, okay. Good.
Okay.
Good.
And I think Joe has gotten transfers from Sharon into that.
Okay. Sort of that's the
dual named account right now.
Good.
Joe's working on doing the bookkeeping.
That makes sense.
Okay.
And I've just got the big picture of the point, borrowing or bonding money to build a transfer station. Who does that? Do the towns do that, or does SSRA do that?
The only times when we've discussed that, Malcolm, it's been thought that SSRA would probably be the authority, would be the one to borrow, but using the towns.
Credit,
because towns can borrow
or ultimately the towns are responsible.
Right. So, and if the SSRA can't get that same favorable rate, then I suppose the towns would borrow and give it to SSRA something like that. So we'll have to work on that.
It's a legal issue, but we want to do it as cheaply as we can.
Yeah.
Well, I remember that was one of the points that we brought up to.
Yeah,
he said that's all up was, do authorities have bonding rates? And he said they do.
They do. They do. And the question is, what will be the repercussions of that? So, okay. I did hear from Janet Lynn that she would like to step down from the building committee. You probably know she had knee surgery and missed some of the board meetings. And so, this would mean we could have a motion to accept her resignation and thank her for the
good motion to accept and regret and thank her for her time.
Okay. Second. All in favor?
Aye.
And replacement. I guess Charlie's away and Ed is out. So we're down to two from Salisbury, and one of them is already a member and alternate member. I'd like to recommend that we consider moving Bob Palmer up into the spot of full member.
Is that official motion?
Would you like to make that?
Yes, I will. Yes, sir. Okay.
But my question was, does building committee have bylaws which require a certain number of members?
Well, we did establish what we wanted on SSRA, right? And we added an alternate slot.
Yes.
Just because there were that many people attending and we wanted them to come up with us.
Right. So I guess the question I'm asking, is it necessary to replace Janet, or can we just cruise along with
what we have? We could, but I think it's good to have equitable numbers shared in Salisbury.
Right.
And we don't have that with Janet's.
Okay. Okay.
So I think there were a good size committee just with current numbers.
Yeah. So there's a motion to have Bob Palmer move to Bill Blaisdell made a motion. Is there a second to that? You seconded that, Tom? Did anybody second that?
I'll second.
Tom seconds. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Then we need to then replace Bob as alternate on the building committee because we still have a vacancy. So
I move that we replace Bob and Ed Reagan as alternate.
Is there that? Okay. Who seconded it? Okay. Hope I can remember all these initials. any discussion on that?
Well, Paul, yeah. Ed's been involved with us for a long time. He has a vast background. I would think he'd be very helpful to have him take a full-time
He's been at a lot of meetings.
Right. He's been very interested.
Since the table.
Since there.
Okay. Any other discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? All right. Election of officers for the next fiscal year.
Who are the current officers?
Brent and I think are co-chairs, the two first selectmen, Brent, and Bob is treasurer, Ed is secretary.
Is the current slate willing to serve another year?
Right now, I guess. Yeah, Bob, do. Ned, we can
I would make a motion then that the president, the incumbent slate be endorsed for another year.
And I would read the sign of relief.
All right. So, Malcolm, you
very eloquent second, Malcolm.
That's
a very eloquent second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Other business. This, by the way, is our annual meeting.
Yeah. It's going pretty well.
Yeah. Well, it's easy now because we have the building committee doing all the hard work and track. Advising them, so right, pretty simple for them.
In the end, if this continues,
it's a good way to set it up.
Yeah. Is there a way to begin the discussion on deciding whether the towns will have to borrow the money separately or the authority to do it? Or, I mean, is that a time of borrowing question?
I think it's probably the right time to start exploring that.
Yeah.
And maybe. Brent and I should look at that a little bit with Joe, and would you be willing to help with that, John?
Sure.
With your background in finance. That makes sense.
Yeah.
We might also get help from Webster.
Yeah. Would this be something that would be bonded, or would this be borrowed through a lending institution?
You probably want to bond it. It depends. The bonding it depends on how much money we're going to need. Sometimes the small towns aren't spending enough, and it's bonding is expensive.
Yes, it is.
What it's trying to say. We may find, because we're probably going to try to keep it around 2 million or below, that it will be difficult to bond and justify the cost of bonding.
I guess in Salisbury's case, we're going to spend the next few months really looking at our debt and our, which incidentally has dropped by quite a bit in the last few years. So this would be part of that. And we've done 3 cycles of bond anticipation notes where we're not fully bonding, and each cycle we're required to pay 5% of the principal debt. But we just did this for the 3rd time, and our interest rate is, I think it's 0.68. So it's really low. It's never gone above 0.75%. And somebody did buy those. And those are with Webster. But so I think in Salisbury's case, we're going to be thinking about all our debt.
Sure. Yeah, that makes sense.
We'll include whatever we do have capital.
Interest rates are historically low.
Right.
And they can only go up in the future. So now's a good time for both towns to really look at.
So lock those in. I mean, before we get them locked in, if we don't start till next February.
I don't think you can do that on bonding. I think you have to know the exact number, don't you, John?
Yeah, you borrow a certain amount of money on the bond. The anticipation notes are renewable yearly?
10 months.
10 months.
Yeah,
usually that's
10
years. Yeah. So these are the different strategies that we can look at. And it may be that it's favorable for the towns to borrow money and somehow make an arrangement with SSRA to get the thing built.
I forget, Malcolm, there was something we did that we actually went that route instead of the cost of bond that was going to be.
It was the purchase price that we took out.
That's right.
That we did go bond anticipation on.
Yeah.
Very low interest rate.
Yeah.
And I've forgotten, I think that has to be renewed at the end of the year, or something happens after 12 months.
Nine or 10 months.
Yeah. It's called BAM.
Yeah.
BAMs.
Well, anyways.
Okay, that's a good.
Yeah, the other thing that will probably go with that, I don't want to bring up home again, but is the, in order to sell a piece of paper that has a certain amount of risk with it, and they're guaranteeing the assessment that you go to the bank, your ability to pay back, and it's with the authority, then you will probably need a commitment from the municipalities, like the HRA, to use the facility. And we should start working on that. As much as I hate to add bureaucracy to the whole process, Jim Hart operated for years without it. He doesn't have an interval, which is a different thing. But when I asked him, who signs the contract with CRA? He said the towns used to, now the authority does.
Mm-hmm.
So that will part and parcel with your borrowing. When a financial institution looks at what you're borrowing for, do you have a commitment that you're going to get the revenue stream to, and do you have a the commitment to get rid of that waste? It's a waste supply and disposal, that's what it's called. The towns agree to supply it, and you agree to dispose of it. And it's HRA has Bob Messer with
you. I can do that half of his sleep.
Yeah, I think I have probably copies of it.
Yeah, okay.
But that's something you might think about that goes with, when they look at the risk of what you're doing, they're going to say, well, are you going to get the risk?
Right.
And is it going to pile up over there? Or,
well, maybe the commitment of the town should go first before you even look.
I think they have to go hand in hand. And to be honest with you, the town isn't going to make a commitment until it knows they're walking in almost sequence with each other. Because the town is going to say, geez, do you know how you're going to build this thing? Do you have money to build it? We're going to say, no, but we're going to come back to you for the money. So, and then they're going to say, well, we'll give you the money, do you have this contract in place?
Yeah.
So it's a catch-22 situation. Yeah. They go hand in hand. I don't know, they work.
Okay.
We did.
Incidentally, I think the boards of finance are obviously involved in this, as you know, again. Imagine you talk to them quite regularly, so maybe. Are you on?
Yeah.
Okay.
They actually keep asking for ideas about what we're going to spend.
Okay.
So they it's
on certainly their list. Have you involved with that too.
Yeah, well, I just wrote myself a little note here. You're right about the Board of Finance. That had popped in my head, but the thing that was popping into my head is as follows. We've talked about two mechanisms. One, the towns borrow money, or two, the SSRRA borrows money with the town's credit. But then it seems to me, regardless of which of those mechanisms follow, it leads to two separate town meetings.
Mm-hmm.
Because the townspeople have to have the right and opportunity to vote upon that borrowing, regardless of which way it's done.
Yep.
I mean, each town has to vote. So
yeah.
Yes.
Right. Either the town meeting gives the town's good credit to the
right.
authority, or they borrow the money for the
right.
You're right.
Right.
It's called the correct term is the town pledges its full faith and credit behind the bond or whatever it is. And it's done by the legislative body, which is town meeting.
Yeah.
And then, since it's financial, every property holder can vote.
Correct.
Yeah. Is it $2,000 assessed value now?
Is it two?
It used to be $1,000, but I think
it's
two.
Yeah.
But that will, the reason why it's good that you brought it up is. In order for us to put a shovel on the ground beyond what funds we have in the bank, we're going to need to have that money available.
You wouldn't want to go, I wouldn't want to go to the towns at the town meeting without having some pretty accurate number.
You got to have a plan. You got to have a plan.
It would be even better to have it bid out
so
that you actually knew.
But we also need a good PowerPoint presentation. This is what we're going to look like. This is what we want physically. This is what the operation will be. I mean, this has to be, it's a lot of money. They have to go to voting on it.
Yeah. Absolutely.
I'm married to someone who makes an interesting point.
All right.
Interesting observation that a PowerPoint presentation is for people to see. And she thinks it's better to talk to people. You know, stand up and talk to them. Maybe give them bullet points, right?
This would need to be bullet points.
Because you're going to be.
It's got to be a presentation. I agree.
It's
got to be an organized presentation.
Yeah. It doesn't have to be PowerPoint, but it should be. They need to know what this is going to look like. Right?
Yeah. Okay, so.
At what point are we. Well, the building committee would have to decide when we have enough schematic to. You could put it up on both websites.
By the fall. I think I remember when we met in Haddam, our hope was to break ground in 14, but not necessarily build up. Isn't it correct? But that was a goal, and I don't think we lost a little bit of time, but I don't think we've lost a huge amount of time.
I would feel comfortable, sooner rather than later, the more the public can learn, the more we can show them. Look at it, feel if there's what support is there, what isn't, and what the general feeling is. And that's going to make a big difference on what we do. And if we have this big cloud out there and no one's happy with it, then we need to know that.
Yeah. Well, maybe the September selectmen's meetings, we should each have the same agenda item and talk about this. I give the building committee the rest of this.
The building committee committed this slide, and we've been.
Yeah.
They agree what we've been doing.
September or October,
maybe August or.
Maybe October to let some of these financial questions get answered as well. And then we schedule some public review and, sort of informational meetings in October. That makes sense, whether they're at the Board of Finance meeting. Special. Yeah. We could even do both towns together in a place maybe like Hotchkiss that would fit that many people. Okay.
I think it's going to be a relatively important part of the building. So it's probably more.
Plus, to tell you the truth, giving the building committee a deadline is not a bad thing. I think, as being a member of it, it says you got to have it done by then, folks.
Well, I know one member would be happy to hear what
you're saying.
Okay. Any other business? No? Any members? Anything? Citizen comments? Any?
Close that.
Okay. Motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Okay.